Cheers from Nuked London, home of the best three-eyed fish and chips in the Milky Way. The Patriots hooligans have been drinking all morning here outside Flumbly Stadium, and they are ready for blood. Today's matchup features the two teams who survived the regular season and playoffs. Tonight, they go to war in the mayhem. The Microhard Mutilators face off against the Blitzburg Steelheads. Welcome to Mayhem Bowl Sunday. Harbo and Grim Blitzro here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and see what the team captains have to say. And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitzro with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Bricks. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of them.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And he laterals the ball. Man, these guys like play. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate.
One, hot two.
First and ten. The defense is back on their heels and the offense just keeps rolling.
Speaking of that, where's my papers?
And it's first and ten.
Wrestling?
Second down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked porta john in here.
We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen.
Don't nobody want a match.
And that'll bring up third and one.
Hot one, hot two.
Says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and never gonna happen. Sadly to the wrong team.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And so at the end of the first quarter, we've got a scoreless game.
Just like you love life.
And it's first and 10. Some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, he just got crushed. 2 minutes remain in the half.
Wait, I gotta take a dump.
Again, you just went. How is that even possible?
It's the nachos, man.
And the defense jumps outside to the tech. And that unsportsmanlike play of the day brought to you by the good folks at Speedy's Drive-Thru Funeral Parlor Service, located just off the Beltway, exit 5. First and 8 to go. Second and 8 to go. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beef boost inject, and the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown!
Now, this guy looks kind of familiar.
Yeah, he was in that 80s band, Men Without Heads. Remember? We can dance if we want to.
Not bad for a guy 100 years old. He's aged better than Keith Richards.
For the extra point. Strike through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. This guy's a brick shithouse. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
And mentally is Shark the Monkey. Thunderclap. That was a bone crusher right there, folks. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected.
return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. Satan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
Well, that was one hell of a mayhem ball halftime show, Bricks. They'll be talking about the Justin Greaver's jockstrap malfunction for years to come.
Yeah, by the time the match finally got to him, there was more blood spilled on the stage than on the field. And I hope they just sew that thing back on.
Hell, me too, partner. We have got a deadlock game here, folks, as they kick off the ball.
I hope they sew it on the little bastard's forehead.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Second and one. For a 10-yard gain. Third and four.
Hot one, hot two.
And he laterals at the last second. It's 2-yard run before he stopped. Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick. Teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. And look at that ref.
Holy mother of blown up mutants right in his face. Yeah, actually, might be an improvement. That guy was ugly.
defense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. To an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. Third down in the offense, and the defense jumps outside trying to, and the whistle blows the play dead along with the quarterback. The offense is running low on quarterbacks, and only two left. You might consider running the ball more. Point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Thank you. needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
Well, V-5-5-5.
I'm not finishing that joke, Grim.
Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least...
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And that'll be second down and four. How do you like your defensive cook? The ball carrier saying, well done.
Bang, baby, bang.
He could go all the way. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Here, just kicked the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. That is a lousy kickoff. The offense is going to have great field position. Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponent.
I want to take a beast boost injection too.
Now that is weird side effects, Bricks. Man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking?
I mean, when they're not young.
We are witnessing a classic as we head into overtime here at the Mayhem Bowl. A big shout out to our advertisers who are getting plenty of bonus ad space.
All hail our evil corporate overlords.
Time in the Mayhem Bowl. The teams line up for the kickoff, and at the end of this game, one will be crowned Galaxy Champion. And it's first and ten. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and six. He had it for a second there. Third down and six. Second down and 10. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up third and one. Nicely done for a first down. Thank you. Once again, the folks at Evil Ozan thank our viewing audience and the Newton Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brick and Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Are we off now?
All right, whose turn is it to buy the rounds?
It's Junior's. I bought last year.
Hey, screw you. Everyone knows it's your turn. You're a lying pansy.
I could have sworn I paid last time.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...